Hello, hello everybody. Hello YouTube. Just testing my levels here. Got a slightly different setup than usual. Because I'm using a standing desk and I have my microphone on a tripod. I'm seeing if everything sounds good. And yeah, it seems pretty good. If there's any problems, feel free to let me know with audio. But it should be okay. Seems okay. Maybe lower the music just a tad. That's probably a little bit better. That way it's not quite so loud. Maybe a little more. Like that? Does that make any difference? Oh yeah, that is, okay. Maybe put it a little bit higher. The music sounds better than my voice anyway. Alrighty, let me get my screen up here. Bump. There we go. So tonight, if you read the title, I am working on this Barrett painting that I've been meaning to get back to for a while. I did a Tifa one a little while ago that was like trying a new sort of workflow, and this is sort of a continuation of that, but I'm taking this one a lot further than I took the Tifa one, so we're gonna see how it goes. I haven't really worked up his face yet, it's still very sketchy. Hey, Darth Alien, thank you. Yeah, I like how the contrast is so far. I think it's coming along pretty well. I started from this sketch. I'll show you. Let me see. So this is what I started with. This was the rough sketch. And so far I've worked it up to about here. So not too bad. Making progress. Getting there. So yeah, I'm just going to be painting. Feel free to talk amongst yourselves, ask questions if you want to. I'll make sure to look at the chat. And I'm going to get going on this. Got my coffee. Glad about that. I'm also super happy because my garbage man decided not to pick up my barrels today for some reason, so I get to have trash filled barrels for another week. Super cool. Super happy kind of thing. It's always fun. Alright, so where was I on this thing? When I last worked on it, I think. Okay. It's on the gun here. Yeah, so I was just putting in the values on the gun arm. Darth Alien asks, have you played the Ori games? I'm playing them now. The Ori games? I'm not sure. That doesn't sound familiar. Ori? What are they about? Makes me think of like Onimusha or something for some reason. I don't think that's it though. Okay, so on this part, oh, I see how that is, okay. So I didn't quite finish this. Try not to zoom in too much, but working on sort of a tight area here. Thank you. Ori the Will of the Wisps. They're Metroidvania games with super cool hand-drawn graphics. Oh, no, I haven't heard of that. I don't think I've seen that one. I'll have to check that out. What's the style of the graphics on that? Is it like super stylized? I know that that one game had really cool stylized look that copied Bloodborne. What was the name of that game? Blasphemous? That was pretty cool. I think that was pixel art though. 2D vibrant and reminds you of Pixar. Okay, I see. Yeah, that's definitely different than the Blasphemous. That's kind of the opposite of Pixar. That's cool though. Yeah, I'll have to check that out. I haven't seen it. Ori, the Will of the Wisps. Very cool. You play a lot of platformers, don't you, Darth Hylian? I think you're always telling me about a platformer that you're playing. I don't play that many platformers. Personally. I do like them, though. I always feel like I was a bit spoiled by, like, Mega Man X. It's such a good platformer that it made me kind of not want to play any other platformers. That and like Metroid, you know, the old ones. My music jumped up a little bit, did it? Is it too loud? If that music's too loud, let me know, Darth Hylian. Blasphemous has really appealing style too. Yeah, I'm into them lately because they're shorter and satisfying. Yeah, it's good stuff for sure. Music's good? Okay, cool. Oh, that's right, I forgot. I'm listening on a different headphone, so it's not even the volume, yeah. That's why I thought it was loud. There we go. Cool. Alrighty. So that's gonna be just like a sort of a little line that softens towards the bottom. Something like this. I think it gets a little warply, so I have to fix that now. It's probably fine. And then here, it's gonna do something a little different, I think. Had in mind, so I want to get it just as dark on the bottom area here. As it comes up, there's gonna be just a little, not even quite this light, but like a ghost of that, like sort of this, just kind of there with the hard edge on the bottom, and it's gonna blend up a little bit into more dark. That's graduating to that metal tone. And the metal tone starts a little bit lower than it does over here. And then that highlight's blocked in the right place. Yeah. I'm sort of dreading rendering these fingers out because there's a lot of little subtle plane changes that I managed to kind of block in there, and I'm afraid of losing a lot of that when I try to clean it up, but it's gotta be done. Soften those edges a little bit. I should kind of zoom in for that a touch so I can see what I'm doing here. Yeah, that looks pretty good. I finally found some new music that I can use on YouTube. This, FF7 lofi. They say permission to use on streams and stuff as long as you give credit, which I did in the description, so that's cool. I kept using the Zelda and Chill for everything because I just knew it worked and I didn't want to go searching around for new music all the time, but I'm starting to find some new ones to incorporate in so we're not all listening to the same thing every time. It's a little boring. And this fits because it's Final Fantasy VII. And we're painting Barrett. And this is going to be actually a very gradual plane change. And the light kind of dominates it. She keeps it a little bit. The FF7 soundtrack is so good. I could probably listen to it for quite a long time without getting bored, to be honest. Starting to get there. Still weighted a little bit more to the light, I think. Needs to be. Aerith's theme is quite good. Freaking Rebirth broke my heart. Not to like spoil if you haven't, you know, played it yet, but they do, you know, just like in Remake, they do kind of change some things. And at the end, I really thought they were gonna let you save Aerith this time, and it doesn't seem like that's really what happened. So maybe they'll continue that thread somehow in the next installment, but yeah, they tricked me. I really thought you were gonna be able to save her, and I really didn't want that because the story is good, because, you know, part of the reason why it was so good is because there's like sacrifices and stakes and people die. And Earth dying's a big part of the story. But I mean, when I was playing through Rebirth, I started to get really attached to the idea that they were gonna let you save Aerith somehow. And so then when it actually came around, I was really bummed that that didn't really happen. They played with my emotions. Such a bummer. But yeah, they might carry that through somehow in the next one. Obviously it's a little different, because Cloud's wigging out and seeing stuff. So there's potential for something to be a little different there. It's getting there. Could be a little smoother. I really liked Rebirth though. I thought it was great. I think a lot of people complained that there were too many mini games and too much side content, but if you think about that section of the original, there were a lot of mini games and side content. So it's not like that much of a deviation from the original. Although they did pack a lot more in, obviously. So it's different, but I thought it was all very well done, personally. Darth Hylian says, I'm waiting for Rebirth on PC. Oh, I'm sorry. Hope I didn't spoil anything. But I mean, you know the original story, right? With Aerith and all that. I think it's going to be a while before it's on PC.
Fentanyl can be mixed into heroin, cocaine, press pills, meth, and other drugs.
It could be. Did they even say when it'll be on PC? I bet they haven't yet.
Learn more at go.cdph.ca.gov/fentanyl. Sponsored by the California.
That's good. So I didn't spoil anything too much, thankfully. Sorry about that. Oh, you played last year for the first time? That's cool. Yeah, you know, I didn't play it when I was really, really little kid. I wound up playing it. It came out when I was like, when did it come out? 98. I think I was like in second grade. I didn't wind up playing it until I was like in junior high. And I played the crap out of it in junior high. I totally fell in love with it. It's such a great game. Yeah, I think it's still worth going back and playing if people can stomach the, you know, just the dated nature of it, because can't deny it is very dated, that's for sure. So I think it's worth experiencing though, especially if somebody likes JRPGs and they're sort of, they have a stomach for that sort of thing. Old JRPGs, I mean. It's definitely one worth experiencing. I need to go back and play FF9, because I never played all that one. I think I only ever played the beginning. And that one's supposed to be one of the best ones. So, some point I will make time for that. Someday. Who knows when. So much to do. Zoom out and see what I'm doing here. Yeah, I don't like how that looks quite yet. It's getting there though. I have super vague memories of watching someone play FF7 when I was 5. That's interesting. Just little fragments. I have that for something. I have that for Star Wars actually. I remember the first time I ever saw Star Wars. My dad was just flipping through channels on the TV, and he came across the scene in Empire Strikes Back was on TV where Luke is fighting Vader in front of the big window, right before Vader throws him through the window onto the ledge. And from that was the first time I ever saw anything Star Wars, and that moment is stuck in my head forever. I still remember exactly where I was, like, standing in front of the TV and just looking at that. Like, the coolest thing I had ever seen up until that point. Still one of the coolest fights in Star Wars, that's for sure. Yeah, that blew me away as a kid. I was like, what the heck is that? And he's like, oh, it's Star Wars. It does not want to get chicken out. It's not Canadian. Yeah. Yeah, Star Wars, it was definitely great to grow up watching Star Wars. Even when the Phantom Menace and the prequels came out, I was young enough that, like, I didn't have that hate for them that a lot of older people did, who, like, I think it's because they, like, grew up with, like, they were young in the 70s, and they saw the original Star Wars and the original trilogy as they got older. But that was all there really was. There was some expanded universe stuff, but there wasn't like this whole lore where everybody knew everything about Star Wars. So a lot of people, over years of not getting new movies and things, they would just fill in information for themselves and come up with their own theories. And so after a while, you know, their theories became more important to them than like anything that anyone could have written. So I think at that point, like, when the prequels came out, people were just like, what? This isn't what I thought it was at all. And they were really upset. But, that's my speculation as to why people hate it so much, because, I mean, they're not great movies, by movie standards, like, as far as, like, you know, like, high-end movies or anything, I guess, whatever that means. But they're very entertaining, and, you know, the end of the day, they're for kids, so they are what they are. But yeah, as a kid, I loved all the prequels. Darth Eileen says, yep, and people hate the CGI, but I don't mind it. There wasn't as much CGI as people assume. Yeah, I thought the same thing, and maybe that was because I was younger too. Like, the CGI didn't seem as egregious to me when I was a kid. When I go back now and, like, you see, like, the big boss Gungan guy and he shakes his face and all that, yeah, it looks pretty bad, especially now. But, like, as a kid, it didn't bother me at all. I totally bought all that stuff. I didn't think it looked fake or anything. I didn't know any better. To me, it was all amazing. I hear that complaint a lot about in Revenge of the Sith, when Anakin and Obi-Wan were fighting on Mustafar, and people are like, oh, they're just fighting on green screen for like 30 minutes, who cares? And it's like, well, yeah, what would you want them to do, fight in a volcano and film that? Like, what are they gonna do? What else could they possibly, how would they shoot that, you know? Kind of a weird complaint. I think people get too caught up in special effects sometimes. It's always nice to see really good special effects, but it's just a means to the end that is telling the story. At the end of the day, it shouldn't just be about that. My favorite thing about Star Wars is the world building, characters, and planets, Star Tatooine says. Yeah, it's got really great world building. That might be the thing that George Lucas really did better than anything else, was come up with a really interesting world. Because I have great respect and admiration for George Lucas, but I mean, people have kind of pointed out, you know, he's not necessarily like the best director, and I think he kind of knows that, which is why he has a lot of other people direct, or back then even he had a lot of other people direct Star Wars for him, and he had a lot of help There's that whole thing about how Star Wars was saved in the edit, the original one. But his world building and just the world that he created, and the theming of it, I think, as well, is so good. And that's something that not just anyone could do. So he's definitely very special in that way, if not so much as a director. I've never seen his work that isn't Star Wars, though. I know he's done a few other films, so maybe there's better stuff there, I'm not sure, but as far as directing goes. I should watch his other films at some point. It'd be worth doing, for sure. Yeah, I was really bummed. Speaking of the world building in Star Wars, I was very bummed out when they canceled that Star Wars 1313 game that they showed the trailers for way back in like 2000. I don't even know at this point. It was probably 2013 or 14, around then. And it was going to be all about the Coruscant underworld and the crime that happens down there, and you were going to play as, I think initially they just, when they showed that trailer, the gameplay trailer, they said you were going to play as just a random smuggler, but as it turns out, it was actually going to be the story about Boba Fett and how he came to become a great bounty hunter. And I will never forgive Disney for canceling that, because that looked so cool. He made Indiana Jones 2. He helped work on Indiana Jones, but Steven Spielberg made that was Steven Spielberg's thing. They're buddies, so they go back and forth helping each other on projects and things. But he definitely was the head on... Spielberg was the head on Indiana Jones, I think. I think they were that new Hollywood generation of directors, or whatever they used to call them, back in the 90s and 2000s. They kind of came up together. There was another guy who was in that group who they were all buddies with. I can't remember who he was. It's quite a legacy. Made some wild movies. Yeah, 1313 would have been really cool. Damn Disney. There's that weird Star Wars game that they haven't shown much of yet. It's called, Eclipse? Star Wars Eclipse or something Eclipse? The trailer for that looked really cool, just the tone of it. It seemed kind of dark and mysterious. And it's made by... I think it's being made by Quantic Dream. But it's not going to be like a Quantic Dream game. It's going to be like an action RPG. So there's a lot of variables there, because I don't think they've ever really made an action... Was it action RPG or action adventure? I can't remember. But they haven't made a game quite like that, so... Be interesting to see how that goes. But the trailer looks very good. They make very good cinematic stuff, that's for sure. Quantic Dream. They made, like, Detroit Become Human and... Heavy Rain and all those sort of interactive narrative games. That background, how did I make it? What kind of brushes? It was one brush, and it's a Photoshop brush. I was in Photoshop working on some of this, and It is a brush that I got from Dave Raposa from one of his brush packs. If you don't know who he is, he's an amazing illustrator. And you can check out his brush pack on his Patreon or on, yeah, I think it's through his Patreon. He gives out his brushes. And it's in his most recent video that he posted about how he paints Venom. And you can download the brush packs there, I think, if you subscribe to his Patreon. It's only $5 and it's really worth it. He has a ton of tutorials. I highly recommend it. I subscribe to him. Yeah, it's a great brush for just roughing in sort of a really rough, crazy texture. If that's something that you're looking for, it's very good for that. He's got a lot of good brushes. This might actually be a little bit of a sharper edge. Yeah, no problem. See, I feel like this is too low. Yeah. Look at it. It's a little better. Going on a trip and then getting sick got me in an art rut, says Darth Alien. Oh, that's a bummer. Going on a trip should get you, like, excited to make art, not put you in a rut. What kind of trip was it? Was it like a business trip? That could put you in a rut. But if you're just going like seeing some nature or something, that should be fun. A road trip, should be inspiring. Getting sick though, that sucks, yeah. That always sucks. Yeah, but I mean, I was really busy on the trip and couldn't draw. Oh, I see. Yeah. So you just kind of fell out of the groove of things. Yeah, that could happen for sure. One thing I like to do that keeps me from getting into ruts like that is anytime I have an idea for something that I want to draw, like a series or like a... Like, right now I'm doing this series of Final Fantasy VII characters, or like a series of illustrations or fan art or whatever. I always write it down in a notepad in my phone, a little note document. And so then if I ever feel like I'm in an art rut, I can just go to that note document and I have tons of ideas that I've just written down over at different times of stuff that I've wanted to draw. And that usually snaps me out of it. Because I'll see something there inevitably that will catch my attention and I'll be like, oh yeah, that could be fun. So it's good to always make a note of anything that you feel like drawing. If you don't have time to draw it right away, it can be helpful. Yeah, I have so many freaking projects in that notepad, I think I'll never be able to finish it in my lifetime. So many things. also watching some other artists' work. If you watch tutorials or even a stream or something, that can get you in the mood to draw again too. That usually works for me, especially if someone's like demonstrating a technique that that I'm interested in trying. I'll usually jump on my tablet and start following along. Stuff like that. Okay, I blocked in the gun a little faster than I thought I would be able to.
Before Shopify,
so that's nice.
Where are my sales at?
But it's a little rough here Shopify, still, but I'll just go in and fill that in. Smooth it where it needs it here and there.
To ignite their selling. Sign up for a $1 per month trial period at shopify.com.
How did that one get so much smoother? I think because I went over it more with like a mid-tone or an in-between tone. Probably did something like this, right? Where I just kind of smoothed everything. I think that's what I did. Just brought it all down a notch. Like better. Maybe not. No, because I want it to be lighter there, that's the thing. So I grabbed the wrong tone here. That's better. Yeah, I think I put more of a bass down and I didn't just use quite so many lines like that. That's probably why that one's smoother. Yeah, it's better. Just fill in some of those strokes. Probably even go back over a little bit. Bring some of that back. Getting there. Alright, it's not quite as smooth as I want yet, but I'm gonna move on to something else. So I don't go crazy. I could finish up that buckle. I could work on that sort of rim part, which is actually very shiny, I think. So, yeah, maybe I'll do that. Watch my line. Oh, I don't have line for that. That's interesting. I wonder. Oh, because I already incorporated it. That's why. Okay. Yeah. Alrighty. I'll just have to clean it up by feel then. Pretty cool take on One Winged Angel. I dig that, actually. Thank you. How many layers do I have? Right now, I'm only working on two. I have this one that I'm sort of doing new stuff on. And then I have this one underneath. But what I kind of do is, as I work, I'll save layers. Just in case I want to go back a step if I do something I don't like. So I have some backup layers, like from earlier. Like this one. Before I work the gun in. And like this one from even earlier. And this is the sketch that I started with. And then the background layer. But I'm only working on this, this layer. And this layer. So after I work on the new layer for a while, and I'm happy with how everything looks, I'll just incorporate it into the lower layer. Or I'll duplicate the lower layer and then incorporate it. I also have a line layer that I'm referencing, which is the drawing that I did, or part of it. Which, it's hard to see with that on, but this is part of it. So I can just reference that when I want to add in the details that are missing. Like all that stuff on his pockets of his jacket, I gotta add that in, you know, all that junk. But yeah, mostly just working on one or two layers right now. Wow, huh? I need to try limiting my layers, and dang, even your line art looks badass. Thanks, Darth Alien. Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I use a lot of layers. It just depends what you're working on, really. Like, if I'm working on... Like, when I get to the painting stage, I'll probably do a different layer for, you know, all the different sort of color block-ins and stuff. And depending on what you're doing, sometimes it's good to have a lot of layers. It just depends. But yeah, you can try to limit your layers if you feel like it. Can be good sometimes. Yeah, lately I've been trying to work up my line art to a much more finished level than I normally do for paintings, just because I feel like I need the drawing practice. Because no matter how much better I get at drawing, I always feel like I'm behind where I should be, and I should be a little bit better at drawing, and it would just be easier and faster to get things done if I was just a little bit better than I actually am. So I don't know, I always feel like I'm a bit behind, I guess is what I'm saying, on my drawing chops, because I can render pretty well, but not as good at drawing it as I am at rendering, I think. So I'm trying to practice more.
Universal Studios Hollywood is turning 60. For a limited time, step off the tram and onto the back lot.
That's a little bit too dark, probably. 60 years now through August 11th. Soften that up. UniversalStudiosHollywood.com for details. Maybe push it back a little too, because it reaches out kind of far for just being that little belt shadow. Probably a little better. Alright, let's see. I'm starting to get finicky with stuff. Yeah, I'm still working on the rim of that gun. I want to push this highlight back a little bit. I don't want it to extend quite this far, I think. And then the top part is, yeah, it does get really dark like this, so that's good. Just simplify that and pull it down. And then it softens right away. Okay, so that's not bad. I want to pick that metal part out because it does have a little more definition than what's there. Did it already switch over to Zelda? Yeah, it did. That's cool. That's good, Darth Atlane says. Lots of artists stay in their comfort zone. Yeah, it's true. I've been in that phase before, for sure. I think everybody does that sometimes. You gotta rest sometimes. You gotta, like, you know. You don't want to stick at a plateau for too long, but sometimes you need to rest at the plateau, I guess. It's human nature. But yeah, some people, I mean, I think it's fine if, like, you're in a place where you're pretty satisfied with your work and, like, you're not really looking to improve anything in particular. You know, there's nothing wrong with that if you're just kind of doing your thing. But I do see a lot of artists who, like, over years and years and years, they just kind of don't really improve. They just kind of stay how they are. So that can happen for sure. You definitely have to be actively, you know, trying to get better, or after a certain point, or else you're probably not going to get any better. In the beginning, it's just like the more you draw, the better you'll get, because you just, you know, you're just kind of learning the basics. But it does come a point where you're starting to say, what do I need to work on? And really sort of figure that out and work on it if you want to get better at it. Yeah, something about this spot, I'm not quite feeling the form of it yet, so I'm gonna have to figure out what that is that's not working there. It's probably just a contrast thing, especially with, like, this part. I feel like this is not getting enough contrast. I wonder if I could do, let's block something in here really quickly. I don't think it really needs that right there, but maybe, like, kind of grade it up. That'd probably make more sense, right? That's probably a little better, yeah. Yeah, it's starting to look a little bit better, I think. So, I think it's a contrast, though. I think some people choose a style too soon, says Darth Atlane. Yeah, that could be a thing, too. I think maybe, yeah. Like, if some people, but again, like, if that's all they want to do, I think it's fine. Like, you don't necessarily have to be, you know, chasing after anything else. But I do notice some people will get caught in, like, a kind of a generic anime style, or, like, kind of a generic Tumblr style or, you know, one of those kinds of things. And they'll get, you know, really good at sort of emulating that, and then they just sort of don't grow from there. They just sort of always do that. And that's fine, but, you know, there's a lot of people who do those styles, so I do think you kind of have to innovate a little bit and do something a little different if you want people to notice your work. You have to change something. You have to add a little bit more of yourself into it, I think. Of your own personality. Yeah, I do think that little bit of contrast there helped already. Okay, I'm trying to think what would be good to... I'm sort of avoiding the face, and I'm sort of avoiding that hand. I talked about that. I'm sort of like not wanting to do that. So maybe if I'm not going to do that right now, I'll focus on this, putting some of the details into this jacket, because there's a lot of stuff that's not there yet. So... I need to fix the folds in the pants a little bit too. Maybe I'll do that first. Nice zoom in on Barrett's crotch there. Darthalian says the hand looks pretty great already. Thank you. Yeah, I sort of blocked in the general plane changes and stuff reasonably well, so I'm afraid to work on it because I know I'm gonna... I shouldn't say that. I'm just worried that I'm gonna screw something up. I'm gonna lose some of the energy that's going nicely there. But that's the name of the game. Gotta do it. Can't leave it. Gotta work things in. Can't be afraid of that stuff. That's why I'm going to work on his pants instead, because of how not afraid I am of that. Yeah, this is all kinds of weird. This should be like... This should be a much softer highlight. Not quite so intense. And then this part should... Oh, I see, because it's bending back, so it's catching the lip. That's fine. Okay. That makes sense. This part shouldn't really be all that light at all. There a little bit more, kind of flattens out, and then it becomes the sharp edge again. Okay, it's starting to look a little more reasonable. I don't think it's following the line art very closely though, is it? Oh no, it is, yeah. Mostly. Okay. probably just pull this part out a little bit more so it's not quite so. High up there. I see what's bothering me. It's this bright spot. It's making it look like it's pulling up way higher than it is or something. That's looking better. Still be a little softer. This highlight's still a little too harsh for where it is and what it is. Because that fabric's pretty freaking matte. It's not very shiny. Darken up a lot of that. Yeah, I think that's better. I kind of lost it though. A little bit lighter. Darth Hylian says, can I see the reference for the pose? Yeah, hold up. Let me see. I'm streaming from my laptop, so it's not on my laptop. It's on my other computer. But I think I can change it to a different display. This one? Nope. That's not it. It's this one, right? No, it's not. That's weird. It should be maybe source 2. It's this thing. Video capture. This display capture. Why does this one go dark? It should be this one, shouldn't it? I'll just open it on my laptop real quick. That'll be easier. Make sure I'm not showing any projects that I'm not allowed to show. Give me one sec. Okay. This one. Oh no, it's. Yeah, it's workflow. And then riff. Nope, it's workflow. And then projects. Okay, popping it up right now. Oh, let's turn that back on. There we go. It's loading. It's a big file. Shouldn't take that long. Wow, that's taking an obnoxiously long time. What is wrong? Here, let me try to close it, because it doesn't seem like it's working. I'm gonna try to open it again. Is it opening? Dark Lion's like, that's all right, man. Thanks. Don't worry about it. Yeah, sorry. I don't know why it's not opening. I don't think, I think maybe God doesn't want you to see my reference. Let me try one more time. I don't know why it's not opening. Now I can't even get it to start. Oh, there it goes. Now it's working. Man, Pure Ref is struggling. I've never seen this before. I don't know why it's having so much trouble. Is this the right file? These are my storyboards. Oh yeah, this is the same file. Yeah. So if you look at the Barrett stuff over here, this is what I'm working from. So I have just some general reference for Barrett that's from Rebirth. That's the costume that I'm kind of looking at for the details of his coat and all that stuff. And then I built this in 3D, which is just a rough, you know, buff guy. And I built the gun arm to kind of get a sense for how the light is hitting and whatnot. So you can kind of see. That's kind of what I'm working from. And I'm not following it, like, exactly, but it's just kind of, you know, a reference just to help me, like it helped me get the drawing down, like some of this stuff, working from the details, and there's still a lot of stuff that needs to kind of be added, because it's not like a full-fledged Barrett model or anything, but yeah, 3D helps a lot for just general lighting and stuff, so yeah, sorry that took so long to open, I don't know what the heck's wrong with Pure Ref. But I've got that up on my other computer screen right now. Oh wow, great idea with the 3D model, Darth Alien says. Yeah, I've been doing that for a little while now. Trying to build up some 3D models that just act as kind of a general lighting reference. That can be very helpful. Just to get like really specific things, like when you want to see like how exactly a piece of cloth is going to fold, or how the light's going to hit it, or even with the gun, like just kind of guessing what the cylinder light is going to be. Sometimes it helps add a little something to it to have an actual reference to work from for stuff like that. Building the gun was pretty fun too. That was a fun thing to model. I got it pretty close to the forms that Barrett's gun has. I think it's pretty close. If you look at where's like just a straight on angle of his gun, yeah, it's kind of like that. Maybe these discs are a little bit wider, and there's obviously a lot more detail, but I think I did a decent job with it. It's pretty much all there. Or at least like the important stuff, the big shapes. Did you come up with the pose yourself, or was that modeled after a reference to? No, the pose I just came up with. I think I sketched it out, and then, because if you just jump right into posing a model, it can be really stiff. Even this, what I have here is not like super dynamic or anything, but sketching it first and then posing the model to fit the sketch definitely helps you keep things a little less stiff, because if you just start off just posing a model in 3D, it's just not going to be as dynamic as if you just go in and start sketching stuff. So yeah, you definitely got to watch that if you're going to use 3D for posing and stuff. But yeah, it's a pretty simple, you know, just Barrett pose. I just felt like in the game I always see him doing that kind of a thing, so that's just kind of what I wanted to go with. And it kind of matches the Tifa one too. I think I have that somewhere here still. Because I just wanted kind of a side view looking to the right. Oh no, I don't have the Tifa one in here. Oh well. But yeah, I'm going to do one of each character of the main party, and I just want to do all of them kind of in a similar kind of a frame, just a sort of a side view looking to the right, and that'll be a nice series that like would work well for prints or something. I think that's the idea anyway. I'll also get a lot of drawing practice, because I'm going to draw them all really tightly. Kind of cleaned up that part of the pants a little bit. What does my drawing say for that part? Looks like, oh, that whole thing is the fold, is it? I think it is. Okay, so that's not quite all cleaned up yet, is it? Because that would mean this is all part of this. And then the belt is just behind there like that. That's why it's nice to have like a tight drawing to refer back to, because the drawing is where I did all my thinking. Now I'm just making it look, you know, kind of real. Rendering is more like monkey work. Doesn't take as much brain power. Oh, okay, I see. So that peaks right there. And then this is all falling back. So it'd probably be pretty dark. Especially the lower part. It's like that or something. Okay. Alright, so I'm gonna merge this now because I've done about this much on this layer. It's looking pretty good, so I'm gonna duplicate this. And then just merge it down. And I'm gonna start working on these details in the jacket because they're not there yet. Or actually, you know what? I'm not gonna do the details in the jacket yet, because probably be a better idea to just start blocking in some of the face stuff, I think. It's really glaring how rough it is right now. Maybe I'll do that, even though I really don't want to. Face lighting is interesting because it's sort of the front plane is all a little bit on the darker side, and then when it gets here, that's where you're starting to get some of that light coming on that edge. The cheekbone and where the jawbone goes back to here, but the hair is there too, so that's going to soften that light a lot. It's kind of an interesting shape. And then it's gonna go up on that ridge there like that. I curve a little bit more though. And you know what? I can get darker here too, because we don't need to follow that exactly. And right now it's a little obnoxious. It's like too much spreading all over that cheek. So let's just kind of tone it down a little. That's better. And there's a little break in the light there. It's gonna get really softened, and this is gonna soften out as well. And as it turns, it's gonna lose all that. And this definitely angles back a bit, this eyelid. Kinda like that. feel like placement of those scars is not quite right. Because I think his beard comes up a little higher and it covers it a little more. More like this angle, though, kind of meets it. Still just kind of roughing it in so I can get a sense for where that's actually landing. And I think this scar is actually coming back a little bit more, like that, because it's wrapping that plane change of the cheekbone a little bit more, and the other one follows that a little bit more too. So it's kind of the same with this angle. A little better, it's a little less awkward looking. It's kind of hitting the form better. Maybe this under the high part needs to be adjusted too. It actually goes more forward, I think. That first one, so that's kind of a problem. That would mean this one should go out more, actually, like this. Okay, oops. That's not what I wanted. And then kind of go back like this. Towards. Hang on, I gotta look at my reference because I gotta see where it's hitting that eyelid. Yeah, that front scar goes all the way to like almost the inner corner of his eye. It's definitely past the middle of the eyelid. This is like such a tiny thing, you know, most people. I'm not gonna notice. They're not gonna care. But I just kind of want to get it so that it's at least sort of going to the right place. So let's just do a rough kind of block it into that real quick. So if it's going there, it kind of wraps there. Let's just blend all that back to flat. And then that forward one kind of has to come a little bit forward too. Because it's going a little too far forward back. Now we've lost that curve, so we gotta do the curve all over again. So I'm gonna cheat a little bit. Let's see if I can do this and not make it look stupid. Just a little bit like that. And then the angle's gonna come to here. Same thing. That's better, I think. You know what, this one's still kind of off though. I'm just gonna draw it again, this part. Oops. And they also kind of soften as they get down here. They sort of loosen up. They don't really continue into the beard so much. So that's part of it too. Just kind of bring that up a little bit. Yeah, that's a little better. Darth Alien says, I'm gonna head off, but that drawing is looking really promising. Nice work, see ya. No problem. Thanks for hanging out, Darth Alien. Good to see ya. And check out, be sure to check out Dave Raposa's Patreon for those brushes. Still, that's gonna wrap that eye socket a little bit like this. Softens in towards the back of his head. Yeah, even this part does. This is a little bit of a sharper transition. And it's going to be just a little bit darker. Something like that. Better. And even his beard isn't that dark. It's kind of like... a lot of skin showing through. It's not that light either though. It's kind of a little bit too light. A little bit closer. And then his nose is gonna have a brighter spot there, but it's not quite that bright. It's gonna be like maybe like this. Value. That front plane does get a little dark there. Darker than that. Yeah, it's starting to look a little cleaner. Not quite as rough. Excuse me. Maybe I can use, don't I have like a, oh my god, Flip Studio makes it so hard to grab these little things. You tight. Oh my goodness. It's impossible. I'm having so much trouble grabbing this slider. Oh my good! Oh my goodness! I have to use a mouse. It's like not even. It's like turning into the thing. It won't let me grab it. Okay. Use the scroll wheel. Yeah, I wish they would make those a little wider. It's a little bit obnoxious how freaking small those things are. Stupid sliders. Is it this one? This might be the brush I'm looking for. Kinda. I wish it was a little bit more dotted, the texture, but it's kinda working. Can we increase the size of that texture somewhere? There is no texture, is it just a stroke? So just have to increase the size then. Yeah, okay. and erase some of them where I don't want to. Yeah, it needs a lot more work, but that's kind of the gist. It's starting to get that texture in there. Sort of like shortener. Let's soften it off of this highlight a bit. Yeah, it's getting there. Okay, so I think I started at this layer today. No, it was this layer. Yeah. So I got from here to right about here. We could progress for how long have I been streaming? For an hour and 40 minutes, not too bad. Byte VR says, good art, keep it up. Thank you, Byte VR. Thanks for checking out the stream. Yeah, I'm probably... Okay, cool. So, OBS disconnected and reconnected right when I said I was about to stop anyway. So that's good. At least it didn't totally drop me. Yeah. Alright, I'm going to be getting off. If any of you guys got a question or anything before I do, feel free to ask. Otherwise, I'll see you guys on the next one. Hang out for a second here. Just noodle the stuff. Yeah, the face is a lot more cleaned up now. At least the general value planes are kind of in there for the most part. Needs more work though, for sure. Yeah, and I still need to clean up all these buckles and things too. It's going to be very tedious. Alrighty, I'm going to call it a night. Good night, guys. Thanks for checking out the stream. Hope you enjoyed yourselves as much as I enjoyed painting for you. And see you guys on the next one. Bye-bye.